Hi guys, I'm Jaisoni from automatic.com and this is my review video of Carbon A50s. So as you can see, this is the phone and the first thing as you can notice is the screen is pretty washed out of this phone as it is a TFT display and the viewing angles are pretty bad. As you can see, it's getting completely washed out now. So that's one problem of this phone, but it's available for rupees around 2700, so you can't complain. It has a front 1.4 megapixel camera. This is your earpiece, 3 capacitive touch buttons. The build quality of this phone is pretty nice. It has a little texturized back, very glossy and very smudge full. As you can see, it is a fingerprint magnet. On the surroundings, it has this metal like finish, but this is not metal, it is all plastic. Screen size is 3.5 inches. It is resolution of 480 by 320. On the bottom here, it has your USB port and your mic, a little opening to open the back of the phone. On the left, it has the volume rocker, and on the right it has nothing. And here it has your 3.5 millimeter headphone jack and power unlock key. And on the back it has the LED flash and your 2 megapixel camera and your speaker, external speaker. And this is the inside of the phone. This is the battery, 1100 mAh battery, and these are your dual SIM. One is full size SIM and the other one is micro SIM, and this is your micro SD card slot. It supports up to 32 GB. This phone runs on Android. This phone runs on Android version 4.2 Jelly Bean. As you can see, Android version 4.2.2 Jelly Bean. Model is A50s. And apart from that, in the setting, it has got all your usual Android setting, and it also has the default write disk option. You can select phone storage and SD card storage, so the memory won't be a problem for this phone, and you can also move apps to SD card as it also has that option. See, move to internal storage. It is already installed on the memory card because of the default write disk. So there's that. These three touch capacitive buttons, these are sometimes becomes unresponsive for some reason, but not for long. You have to precisely click on the icon, not anywhere near around the area, on the icon only, then it will work. And to go to the multitasking screen, you have to double click the home button. As you can see, this is your menu button. You can select wallpaper, manage apps, or set system settings, whatever you like. And this is your back button. Let's check the music quality now. The speaker of this phone is not that loud. It's right here, and it's not that loud. This is the full volume, by the way. See, and in ears the music quality is good, except that it is a little low on bass. The bass was almost non-existent when I listened to the music through my earphones. And let's see if it can play HD videos or not. Well, as you can see, it is playing the 1080p video, but it is stuttering a lot. Through a third party software like MX Player, I believe it will be able to play the video properly. This is a full HD 1080p video. Let's check the camera now. This has both the icons here, the still image icon and the video recording icon, but you can only do one thing at a time. You can take photos and videos simultaneously. Let me show you. When you press the record button, you won't be able to take the photo. As you can see, it's grayed out. And to pause the recording, just click here and record again. And to save the recording, just do this. This is your flash option. The camera quality isn't that great, as you can see. Even the touch quality isn't that great. These are some of your settings: camera setting, exposure, color, effect, face detection. These are video settings, and it also has panorama and smile detection. And this is for front facing camera. This doesn't have automatic flash option. As you can see, it only has flash off or on. No little A icon here, which illustrates the automatic thing. As you can see, this is the image taken by the camera and it is not that great. So this is the default browser that comes with the phone. You can also download Google Chrome. It doesn't come with Google Chrome. So as you can see, the browser specs wise, it has a dual core 1.2 GHz Cortex A7 CPU and Mali 400MP GPU, but the real bottleneck of this phone is the RAM. It has only 256MB RAM, which is pretty bad, but this is a spare phone, or at the price at which is available at, you can only call it a spare phone. You cannot use it as your primary smartphone. So that's that. Once the page is loaded, it doesn't stutter or lag that much, but while it's loading or the RAM is full, it stutters a lot. I've been using this phone and I noticed that. Let's try the in-browser video.
Hello everyone, my name is Jasoni and this is my unboxing video of car.
In-browser video is working pretty fine. So for a sub 2000 rupees phone, the phone is pretty good, I would say, except for a few things. The screen and RAM and its battery is only 1100 mAh, and it's only going to last you something like 4 or 5 hours if you play games on it constantly or browse net on it. It doesn't have 3G, by the way, it's only a 2G phone. And let's see if this phone supports USB OTG or not. Well, I don't think it is even recognizing the lead. But there are two problems here. First is this Carbon's proprietary USB jack. They are normal USB ports, but the length of them is a little more than the normal. Like this is a normal USB jack length, and let me show you the length of the carbon's USB cables. So you see the length of carbon, this is carbon's USB cable, length of carbon's USB cable is a little more than the normal USB cables. So any normal USB OTG cable won't work on this phone. To sync data on this phone, only carbon USB cable will work, or the one that comes with this phone in the box. So that's it for this review of this Carbon A50 as the cheapest Android smartphone in this world. I hope you liked it or it helped you. If it helped you in any way, please like and subscribe, and also visit my site automatic.com for more. Thanks for watching.